I am Sheikh Mahbub Basha. Welcome to my channel. Happy learning.
Today's topic is verification of Boyle's law. It's a laboratory experiment. Statement: at constant temperature, the pressure of certain amount of a gas is inversely proportional to its volume. P is proportional to 1 by V or PV is equal to constant. When the experimental gas is trapped in a cylindrical column, its radius will be a constant, then PL is equal to constant. L is length of air column. This is a quill tube. One end of the quill tube is closed and there is a fine bore in this tube. You can call it a capillary. So in this fine bore, air is trapped using a mercury pellet. There is a mercury pellet at the center of this tube, and the other end of this quill tube is an open end. One end is closed, another end is open. Now, in this experiment, each time we will be measuring the length of the air column and height of the one end of the mercury column from the experimental table as H1 and the other end of the mercury column from the experimental table as H2. So initially the quill tube is vertical and the closed end is at the bottom. The length of the air column is noted as L and height of the mercury pellet is noted as H1 and H2. From the experimental table it is H1 and from the experimental table it is H2. The table we are using is serial number, position of the tube, length of the air column, mercury pellet positions, closed inside H1, open inside H2, H equal to H2 minus H1, 1 by L, P equal to H plus R minus H, and PL equal to constant. The values of L, H1 and H2 are noted in the table. Now, the position of the quill tube is slightly changed, rotated. As shown here, the length of the air column is noted as L and the height of the mercury pellet end towards the closed end side is noted as H1 and towards the open end side, the height of the mercury pellet from the experimental table is noted as H2. The values of L, H1 and H2 are noted in the table. Now, the position of the quill tube is slightly changed as shown here. Length of air column is noted as L. Height of mercury pellet from the experimental table is noted as H1 and the other end, that is open end side, is noted as H2. The values of L, H1 and H2 are noted in the table. Again, the quill tube is slightly rotated. Now it is horizontal. The length of the air column L is noted and from the experimental table, the two ends of the mercury pellet are equal. So H1, H2 are noted. These values of L, H1 and H2 are noted in the table. Now, the position of the quill tube is slightly changed as shown here. Length of air column is noted as L. Height of mercury pellet from the experimental table is noted as H1 and the other end, that is open end side, is noted as H2. These values of L, H1 and H2 are noted in the table. Of the quill tube is slightly changed, slightly rotated. Length of the air column is noted as L. The height of mercury pellet from the experimental table towards the closed end is noted as H1 and the height of the mercury pellet from the experimental table towards the open end is noted as H2. The values are written in the table. Now the position of the quill tube is rotated. Now the quill tube is vertical, open end is towards the ground. the length of the air column, height of mercury pellets H1 and H2 are noted, and these values L, H1 and H2 are written in the table. The difference in the mercury pellet readings, that is H1 and H2, is calculated and is written in this table. The reciprocal of length of the air column L, that is 1 by L, is calculated and is written in the table. Now, a graph is drawn taking H on x-axis and 1 by L on y-axis. The graph is a straight line with both x and y intercepts. The graph cuts the negative x-axis and that value is noted. The negative x-axis intercept is noted. It is the atmospheric pressure value. Here it is capital H equal to 76.5 centimeters of Hg. So, from the H1 by L graph, we have noted the atmospheric pressure as 76.5 centimeters of mercury column. Now, using the atmospheric pressure value from the graph, the total pressure P equal to capital H plus or minus small h is calculated and is written in the table. And finally, the product of pressure and length of the air column P and L is calculated and is written in the table. If you observe carefully, this product values P into L values are almost close to each other. That means PL is a constant. PL is a constant, or in other words, PV is a constant. That means we have proved that the pressure is inversely proportional to volume of the gas. That means we have verified the Boyle's law.